Very good morning to everyone listening this lecture. The topic of my presentation is going to be guided endodontics, which is currently emerging in endodontics. And I'm Dr. Vinodini, doing final year post graduation. So these are the contents. We are just going to see introduction and 3D printing. What is guided endodontic access and what is retreatment, guided retreatment, guided auto transplantation, guided endodontic surgery, 3D education models, and dynamically guided endodontics. So coming to introduction, after the advent of the 3D printing, DICOM software and CBCD, this has led to an emergence of the virtual planning and the template fabrication, paving the way for the new perspective of treatment called as a guided endodontics. Whether it was introduced first in dentistry, like for endodontics, no. It was introduced first for implant purposes, and later this was like modified by Prasad et al. For endodontics. First it was introduced for the management of the calcified teeth. So I just wanted to tell you what is about something about 3D printing. It is nothing but a manufacturing process whereby you manufacture the material layer by layer, either by addition or subtraction of the material. So coming to the workflow, first you're going to take CBCD standard patient. Okay, you're going to have this in your laptop. Later you'll have to just convert this into a DICOM format. Okay. So because DICOM format could be uploaded into the computer software, and later you have to take the intraoral scanning of the patient. Intraoral scanning of the patient, and you can take extraoral scans, and you have to merge these two scans. So after merging, you are going to plan the treatment. The virtual planning is done in the laptop itself, even before the fabrication of guide. And this is again converted into STL format. And then we are going to fabricate this either of all 3D printing using the various machines which is available. So the next thing is, so I am going to just talk something about guided endodontic access. So coming to guided endodontic access, so one of the most common problem which we face is the pulpy and obliteration, which could be due to variety of reasons. But the complication of this could be, like we are going to get 70% of perforation occurs during the attendant location negotiation with calcified cavities, and also 20% of the perforation of the root, fracture of the file of the root canal was not found as per Civic et al. While we are trying to negotiate a calcified cavity. So to overcome that, Gabriel Castle in 2016 introduced this guided endodontic access. Next. So there is some difference between the guided and the micro-guided. Micro-guided was introduced by T. Conrad et al. In 2018, where the access size is limited. So the burr size, whatever you are going to use, is limited, like 0.85 mm. So indication is the, you know, already obliterated root canals, and then it's the complexities, even in some cases where we are difficult to find the exact location of the canals. And also uncontented access, where previously 95 canals, you can use this guided endodontic access. So the procedure is, first we are going to take a high resolution CBCD of the patient, and then we are going to take a digital intraoral impression. Now we are going to merge these two things with the help of the implant, step 3 is implant planning software. Okay, and after this you have to just see, everything is virtual planning here. See, you have just, the virtual planning is done in the laptop itself, where you just fabricate the position of the position of the burr and position of the guide slip, etc. till wherever you can see the canal, till the entrance of the canal. So, and the next step is like you can just virtually you can see the guide. Okay, this is a template for the guidance of the drill, and now this is exported as the STL language because for easy printing. And this is clinically you can see the guide, and this is the guide which is made up of polystyrene, etc. And here you can see the guide sleeve for exact positioning of the drill, and this is the drill. And motion which you are going to use is the RPM is very less, 10,000 RPM, and using pumping movements. So this is the drill which is used for this guided access. So Conrad et al. Described a technique called as a minimally invasive access cavity. So here you can see, since the minimally invasive thing is the most advancing just happening here. So this is going, like the diameter of drill is about 0.85 mm. So they're going to get a good minimally invasive cavity with the help of the guided endodontic without any microscope. So the next treatment which we are going to see is definitely that there is a chance for perforation, but in guided the deviation is the angle is about 1.81 degree manually. And also as per Condon et al, he compared the substance laws in the normal with conventional is 49.9 millimeter cube, whereas in guided it is going to be 9.8 millimeter cube. And also the treatment time is 21.8 minutes and here it is 11.3 minutes. So next Buckreed et al, he described the technique for, he modified this using the intraoral guides, wherein he fabricated using the composite respiration to overcome the disadvantages of doing it a posterior tube. So next thing is, so we are going to see guided only pre-treatment. Obviously retreatment is one of the challenging thing, and also in addition, suppose if we are going to have any fiber post etc, it's going to make our treatment even more difficult. So we are going to have risk of hydrogenicity like perforation. So here I am going to describe this step. First we have taken an x-ray and we have designed the drill. Okay, after the same method we have designed the drill. Visual planning has been done, and then this is the guide, okay, along with the guide sleeve. And now we are doing the pre-treatment of the patient using the same burr. Okay, now you can see just we have removed the fiber post completely without any deviation. There is complete removal of the fiber post here. Okay, so this is definitely advantageous. So compared to the conventional technique, since we are not in the need to search for the place. Okay. So here, advantage is the sleeve maintains the axis of drill precisely, the axis of the post to be removed. So that is an advantage like overcoming the perforation. So next, treatment 3, the endo. So this is a software I just wanted you people to know about, this dense splice phenomena. So here, this is a CCCD software where even before starting the treatment, you can plan the treatment. Like you can just know about what is the visualization of the canal, even the treatment planning and diagnosis, and what is the size of the instrument you're going to use. Okay, everything, the software just gives you suggestions. Next, so here we're going to see a video.
3D Endo is a straightforward interface to improve the endodontic treatment planning for more easier predictability. First step is we have to isolate the tooth of interest by dragging the view. Then we can go for subsequent steps, which are present at the left corner of the software. So then each canal could be identified and the color coded with a specific color and marked at the coronal entrances and also the apical end. So we can also know the diameter of the lesion. Okay, we can just connect the two dots and know the canal space and know the like curvatures etc, the canal space. And also after knowing this, we can visualize it 3D with each canal in different color for easier identification, complexities of each canal etc. And the next step is estimation of the working length, and this could be done by clicking the suggest box. And also we can move the stopper, and also we can move the file to a more straight line axis and get the working length accordingly. And also the canal entrances could be changed. So then also we can know the axis cavity depth for easier penetration of our instruments. And we can choose the master file from the library of files which are present as per the size of our interest. And we can know the actual canal diameter and the file which we use, the very important thing. And also we can know about the apical width, and we can know, and we will get a report here with the corresponding master apical file, which we can save as PDF.
So we could try using this video in our practice for easier management case. So next. So the next application is guided auto transformation, which has been formed the same year, 2016, by George S. Chabak. So the main objective of successful auto transplantation is preservation of the PDA and also to reduce the extraoral time. So yes. So these are the limitations of the conventional method. So we have to overcome this only guided auto transplantation was taken. So here I'm going to show a case before. This is a preoperative panoramic and a clinical view. So, and here virtual transplantation of the teeth has been done. That is a lower premolar has been transplanted virtually even before extraction into the incisor side. So here the drills have been fabricated. So here the drill has been fabricated with sequential use. Okay. So all the size of drills is different. Okay. So for sequential use, this drill has been fabricated along with that the donor teeth is there. What is the purpose of this is, like after doing the treatment, okay, so we can just, even before extraction with donor teeth, you can just place things in that place to check whether it is fitting properly. So, yeah, as I told you, there are different sizes and also there are different donor teeth to see whether it is fitting properly, and you can do any corrections even before extraction of the donor teeth. So the same case after 12 months recall, you can see this good. It has been done by Chabak et al. So and also there is a systematic review. There is an article by Bedwell et al. You can just go through. It has been concluded like 3D auto transplantation is an effective treatment option for tooth replacement capillary surface patients. So coming to the guided hypnotic surgery, I think most of people you know or you have been practicing this. So it has been invented by Soyeon in 2018. So the success rate of the conventional surgery is 43.5% and it is less than 74%. So the next thing. So because to overcome all the limitation of this guided hypnotic surgery was invented. The indication is difficulty in determining the osteotomy sizing level and root section in the complex cases and to locate the extruded filling material for the precise removal without perforating the sinus membrane. Obviously, we need some guide to do this. So the procedure first is the preoperative X-ray. You can just see the lesion over there. Next. So here for the molar, a drill has been fabricated and this is a visual planning. And see, you can just see designing of the surgical template here. See, it has been beautifully designed. Even the path has been designed where you are going to do this. And this is the clinically what we get, okay, 3D designed template. So we have just inserted our instrument here, so nothing is going to be done here. So like the osteotomy size is going to be very less. The surgical procedure using template described by Kim. So what is the difference in the convention versus guided is preservation of non-pathological osseous tissues in surgery. Binding surgery and also less postoperative complications. You're going to identify the root apices very easily and less operative time obviously, and also soft tissue retraction. Even the guides are available for soft tissue retraction along with it provides an place for your easy identification of the apices, and also it's going to have a favorable outcome and a high success rate. So here, however, further research is needed to investigate the techniques used for this guided hypnotic surgical and its potential benefits in dental education. So, yeah, and also not only for these guides are used for clinical purpose, even for non-clinical purpose, like for doing your 3D education models, it could be used. For advantages of this is you can just multicolor it and also you can store it, you can just sterilize it. 3D visualization, you can see whatever is there inside. So this is definitely better than a plastic model. So it is used as a teaching aid for patient, teaching aid for student on duplication and maintenance of records. And also like in the serial guides. And then for treatment plan. So even before treatment plan, you can get the teeth already. What is there, whatever they which has been present inside bone, you can just get that already. You can just plan for treatment plan. Whether they're going to go for extraction or you can just proceed with endodontics. And also clinically, like simulate access cavity and also for regenerative anatomics to identify the post barrel for the open apices. Okay, simulated apical hemorrhage you can just learn for bare apical surgery also. Even before doing surgery, you can just know the anatomy in depth. Okay. So yeah, this is a 3D. You can just see invasive resorption. Okay, this is a normal tooth. So after doing this, after getting this model, we have a plan for extraction. Okay. So, however, this guides, as we all know, there will be a confusion in our mind whether this is really feasible. There are some drawbacks, like once you have just planned and once you have the guide in your hand, the planned angulation size, depth or the time of the implant cannot be easily changed. Moreover, it's going to have a lot of production cost, time and limited mouth openings also a problem. So, to overcome this, only static guidance was introduced based on the computer-aided surgical navigation technology. So, indication, in all cases like your static, you can use this dynamic, okay? So, yeah. So, first thing I just wanted to tell you, what is this dynamic thing? There are two things which are navigant 1 and navigant 2, okay? So, in navigant 1, we are going to have fix a jaw tag, okay? Jaw tag and handpiece tag. So, this jaw tag is going to be placed in the patient's mouth and the handpiece tag you are going to have in your hand. And also, the patient is going to receive the operator light, okay? And a CBCT scan has been taken and is given the laptop side by side. So, whenever you are doing procedure, all the motions have been tracked by high motion stereoscopic cameras, which you can see directly in the laptop nearby, okay? So, by doing it, it is going to change its color. It is going to accurately tell you whether you have reached your axis or what centimeter and what millimeter and what angulation you have to go to receive the camera. Okay, for example, a beautiful video is there here. Okay, so even before doing the axis, it's going to tell at what depth you have to keep. So at what depth you have to keep, you can just see here beautifully. Okay, and then it is yellow color before receiving the axis. So once you receive the axis, you can see the depth and angle, whatever it tells you, side by side whenever you are having. So once you receive this axis, this yellow color is going to change into red color, okay? So thereby it just gives you a live navigation, which is really an interesting thing. So the next thing which... I just want to tell you something about navigant 2. In navigant 2, instead of having this jaw tag, which is uncomfortable for the patient, they are going to provide us with some landmarks where you can just fix these landmarks in the patient's mouth. So that the jaw tag is not needed, only the handpiece tag to reduce the inconvenience. Okay, so coming to the static versus dynamic guidance. Obviously, static guidance is a disadvantage. We are going to use only 10,000 RPM, whereas in dynamic, we can use normal handpiece by itself and does not require long bursts. Okay, this is normal thing. Dynamic is normal, just we are going to see it. Okay. And also, suppose real time change is, suppose if you want to change the treatment plan, definitely it could be done in dynamic. But in static, it's a doubt, okay? So, on the whole, as per this one, it all is computer-aided static and the dynamic navigation procedures allows more accurate and safe endodontic access to cavities and conventional freehand techniques, eventually used for the beginners. So the most important thing is no microscope here. We does not need microscope if you want to perform these procedure in the guided thing. And operator dependent, it preserves dentin because the angle of deviation is also very, very less. And quicker reduces error and success. Thereby, it is upcoming and emerging in educational, experimental and also in the research purposes. To conclude, this is a promising technique offering a high predictable outcome and a lower risk of iatrogenic damage. Since it is based on limited evidence from case reports and observation studies, in vitro and ex vivo studies, larger population studies with longer follow-up periods are required to take this in the long run. So, I think like I have given in these are my references, like a light on few topics and guided. So definitely it will be helpful to know the if it is going to be in your upcoming future. Okay.